Hello everyone and warm welcome to this session. In this video, we are going to see the details of convolution and deconvolution operation. As far as the convolution operation is concerned, in the field of digital signal processing, it plays very important role. Now, there may be a question in your mind, why convolution is so much important in digital signal processing? The answer to this particular question can be this way. When we are provided the LTI systems, LTI standing for the linear time invariant systems, and we have a certain input, and now we require to know what type of output or exactly what output will be produced by this particular system, so that time the convolution operation is performed. Now, for performing the convolution operation along with the input discrete time sequence, we require another sequence as well. This sequence is called as the unit impulse response, generally denoted as HOPN. It is also named to be unit type impulse response. So when we are provided with the LTI system, linear time invariant system, we can have the determination of unit type impulse response HOPN that is specific to the given LTI system. It is basically relating the system input to the output. So it is giving us information what way the given LTI system will behave when a certain type of input sequence is provided to it. Now let us see how the convolution operation is performed by taking the XOPN, generally the input discrete time sequence, with HOPN, that is the specific unit type impulse response for LTI system. So for finding the output sequence that we will be denoting as YOPN, we are going to perform the digital convolution operation. Now let us see what way mathematical representation of this convolution operation is. So we have represented on the left hand side YOPN. So this is the required output sequence that we need to obtain by the convolution operation. So YOPN we have represented on the left hand side, and that can be obtained by operating over the impulse response HOPK and the input discrete time sequence in this particular form XOPN minus K here. So these two are operated together. And what way the operation is done? The operation is as such, we perform a summation where the index variable k extends from minus infinity to plus infinity for the product of, that means the multiplication of h of k with x of n minus k here. So as we expand this summation to the next step, here we have the series in expansion where we have one term h of minus 1 multiplied to x of n plus 1, which is further added to h of 0 with x of n, further added to h of 1 with x of n minus 1, and again it is added to h of 2 with x of n minus 2. So depending on the length of the input discrete time sequence that is fed to the given linear time invariant system, what we call LTI system, this summation will be expanded here. So how many number of terms in this particular representation will be there, it will all depend on the length of the discrete time sequences here. Now there is simplest way of representing convolution operation in signal processing domain, and it is represented just by putting the asterisk between the impulse response h of n with the input discrete time sequence x of n here. So here you see the asterisk sign here. So y of n can be obtained by convolving x of n with h of n here. So this is what the simple notation, it is conventional notation used everywhere for the convolution operation here. Now most of the time we deal with the causal systems here. So as far as the causal systems are there, we don't have any particular past to that particular system. So we have seen the earlier expression where we obtain Y of n, the output sequence, by convolving x of n with h of n here. So in that particular mathematical representation, we will be making a small change into the order of summation here. So instead of having the infinity, we will start at 0 here, and the new expression can be written as y of n. Here we obtain by making a summation for the index variable k is equal to 0 to infinity instead of starting at minus infinity, where the product of h of k with x of n minus k. If you have h of k with x of n minus k or x of k with h of n minus k, it will be the same here. So this is what the modified equation. If you get the earlier equation to be equation number 1, you can regard this to be the equation number 2. That will be applicable to the causal type of the systems here. Now for such the causal system, if you take, we will be having the few outputs computed here and the relevant equations or the samples into the output sequence we can have in mathematical representation type here. So very first of all, it will be the computation of y of 0. So at the 0th position, it will be the origin of that particular sequence here. So it will be computed, the general representation here we write initially k of minus infinity to infinity for the product of x of k with h of minus k. Here we will be having x of minus 1 multiplied to h of 1, x of 0 with h of 0, x of 1 with h of minus 1, and x of 2 with h of minus 2. These products are summed together, and that summation value of the product, sum of products, will be the resultant value of the sample in the output sequence, what we call y of 0. Now next to that, we will be having y of 1. So y of 1 will be computed here. So here we have the representation of the summation k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity for x of k with h of 1 minus k, where we find the products of x of minus 1 with h of 2, x of 0 with h of 1, x of 1 with h of 0, x of 2 with h of minus 1, and we sum it together. That time we will be obtaining y of 1. Next to this y of 1, we will obtain y of 2 here. So for obtaining y of 2, here we have the summation for the same order for the product of x of k with h of 2 minus k here. So you see the change here, it was h of 1 minus k, where this time we are having h of 2 minus k here. Now here we have the products of x of minus 1 with h of 3, where it was with h of 2 for the earlier case. Now we have x of 0 multiplied to h of 2, where in the previous case it was with h of 1. Next to that, in the similar fashion, we have the modifications as h of 1 multiplied to x of 1, then x of 2 multiplied to h of 0, and these products are summed together, and that time we will obtain y of 2. Now in order to get the hands-on practice for performing convolution operation by using the input discrete time sequence and the impulse response of a particular linear time invariant system, we will be having a practice with the help of a simple problem. So let us have the problem statement here. The problem statement is, using the following sequences, evaluate the digital convolution. The two discrete time sequences are provided to us. Those are denoted as x of k and h of k here. So obvious, the x is the representation for the input sequence to the LTI system, and h is the representation of the unit impulse response of that LTI system here. Now basically, there are two ways for performing the convolution and determining the output sequence here. These two methods are, first of all, the graphical method and then the tabular method. Both the methods are generating the same result here. The graphical methodology is more descriptive than that of the tabular, and tabular method you can regard to be the short method for determining the convolved signal here. So for this particular problem statement, we will be opting the graphical method here. So let us first of all see what are the steps to be performed for determining the convolution of the given two discrete time sequences here. So you just have a look what particular sequences have been given to us. As we have x of k here, you see in the negative side on the k axis we don't have any amplitude here, so this can be regarded as 0, whereas at 0th position we have the amplitude level at 3 here. I just tick mark here. At k is equal to 1 we have the amplitude level 1, at k is equal to 2 we have amplitude 2 here, and next to that we have the amplitude 0. So you can have the input discrete time sequence with 3 samples here. Okay, so at 0th position 3, at the first position amplitude equal to 1, and at the last position we have the amplitude equal to 2 level here. Whereas in the impulse response you have at 0th position the amplitude level equal to 3, then we have here at 2, then here we have the amplitude level 1. So here also we are having the 3 samples into the impulse response here. Now let us see what are the steps to be performed in graphical methodology for determination of the convolution. So using the graphical methodology, first of all we have to make a reversal of the impulse response. Impulse response, as generally we have denoted by h of n or h of k also we can go for, we have to obtain its reverse here. And when we have a reversal, that means the positive side samples will be on negative side and negative side samples on the positive side, so that time instead of having the original representation h of k, the original one, the reversed representation we will denote as h of minus k here. So this is the step number one here. Next to that we have to make a shifting on this h of minus k here. So we will be shifting h of minus k by n number of samples so that we will obtain h of n minus k here. So in the first step we are obtaining h of minus k, in the second step we are going to obtain h of n minus k. I hope you recall the mathematical formulation for performing the convolution here. So we can use x of n as it is, then we can have the product of it with h of n minus k, and then perform the summation of all these products. And another way also we can have the h of k as it is and x of n minus k here. So here we are having the first type of the formulation we have seen here. Now for obtaining this shifting operation, there are the criteria here. The first one, you see, if n is greater than or equal to 0, n means the length of the sequence, so that time h of minus k will be shifted to the right side by n number of samples. And if in the case n is not greater than or equal to 0, it is less than that of the 0, so h of minus k will be shifted to the left side by mod n samples here. So this is all about the step number 2 to be followed in graphical methodology. Whereas in the step number 3, we will be performing the convolution operation as we have seen in that mathematical representation. So it will be the sum of the products here. Products means the multiplication of the two sequences x of k with h of n minus k, so that the output sequence can be denoted by y of n here. And at last there it is, step number 4, which is a repetition of the earlier steps 1, 2, 3 for the next convolution value in the output sequence y of n. So as we have seen earlier, we will be obtaining y of 0, y of 1, y of 2. That way all the sample values in the output sequence y of n we have to obtain by following all these steps here, step number 1, 2, 3 here. So let us recall back the given problem statement and we will be solving it for obtaining y of n here. So first of all, for obtaining the value of the sample that we can denote y of 0 in graphical way, we will have first of all x of k as it is as provided in the problem statement, and here we have the reversal of the impulse response. So reversal is denoted as h of minus k here, And for obtaining the y of 0, we don't require any type of shifting here. So now we can perform the sum of products of x of k with h of minus k, that we can represent as y of 0. And as you see the overlapping between the two here. Now you see at the 0th position we have the amplitude level in x of k is equal to 3. Whereas at the 0th position of x of minus k also we have the amplitude level is equal to 3. So those amplitude levels we put together and we multiply them so that the output value is equal to 9. Now if you talk about the position at minus 1, here the amplitude level is equal to 0. So whatever the value on this particular side of x of minus k is there, that multiplied by 0, the resultant will be equal to 0. Similar is the case with this one, as the amplitude at minus 2 will also be equal to 0. Now we have the amplitudes 1 and 2 on the right hand side of x of k here, but here on the reversal of the impulse response we have the amplitudes at 0 level. That is why only the multiplication will be with x of 0 at this particular position and this one here, the 0th sample in h of minus k, and therefore the value of y of 0 will be equal to 9. Now after obtaining the value of y of 0, we will calculate the value of y of 1 again with the graphical method following the steps those we have seen. So initially we take again the x of k with no shifting, no reversal of the sides here, and for y of 1 here we are having h of minus k plus 1. So the first step we have performed and obtained h of minus k, the reversal of the input sequence, and then we have shifted it by 1 unit. So that is why we can have representation as h of minus k added by 1 here. Now if you overlap these two sequences, those have been represented in graphical manner here for this multiplication here. So you will come to see that the amplitude 1 will be matched with the amplitude 3, and the amplitude 3 will be matched with the amplitude 2 here. So here you see at the 0th level on the x of k we have amplitude 3, it has a matching with amplitude 2 on this particular sequence, whereas this amplitude level at 1 will be matched to amplitude 3 on the impulse response, that is reverse and shifted here. So that is why we can represent the sum of products by y of 1. This sum of product is for x of k with h of 1 minus k, as we have represented. Either you call it h of minus k plus 1 or simply h of 1 minus k. So we will be having 1 into 3 added with 3 into 2. So 1 into 3 will be 3, 3 into 2 will be 6. The addition of 3 and 6 is resulting into the value 9. So for y of 0 we have obtained the value equal to 9, and again for y of 1 by coincidence we are obtaining the value of the output sample equal to 9 again. Now after this y of 1 we shall go for computation of the value for y of 2. Again by graphical method we will have x of k as it is, and now for convolution operation we will be having shifting of the time reversed impulse response again by one more unit. So here we shall be denoting it as h of minus k plus 2, or you can call it to be h of 2 minus k here. Now the sum of products in this particular case will be, here we will be having 2 into 3, then 1 into 2, and then 3 into 1. So here we can see that the overlappings of the 3 samples is possible for both the sequences here. So here the amplitude 3 matched with amplitude 1, amplitude level 1 matched with amplitude 2, the amplitude level 2 matched with amplitude level 3. So the third case is written first of all, then the middle one, and then the first case is written later on. So you see 2 into 3 will be equal to 6, here it will be equal to 2 and here it will be 3. So 6 plus 2, 8 added by 3 will result into the value 11 here. So for the output sample, that is y of 2 is obtained with the value 11 here. So after y of 2, we shall go for computation of y of 3 here. So again we take x of k, and now this time h of 3 minus k, or h of minus k plus 3 here. So here you see there are two overlappings. We have 2 into 2 added with 1 into 1 here. So these are the two positions where we have the overlappings between the two input sequences here, I can say, and the resultant it will be 4 added by 1. So the value is equal to 5 for y of 3 here. So after y of 3, we can have computation of y of 4 here. So we take x of k operated with h of minus k plus 4, and the sum of products in this particular case is the overlapping of only one pair. So we have 2 into 1 here. So this is what the position where the amplitude level is equal to 1, whereas here it is amplitude level 2 here. So 2 into 1, the resultant value will be equal to 2, which is for y of 4. So this way, whatever the possible output samples in y of n were there, we have computed. If you go beyond, because already the impulse response we have time reversed, and then we have shifted it in every step by 1-1 count here. If you go beyond, so that time you have a combination of sum of product for x of k with h of phi minus k. So that time you won't find any kind of overlapping. That is why in this particular case, y of phi, or in general if you represent y of n, that will be equal to 0. So for the n greater than 4, we are obtaining all those output sample values will be equal to 0, because there is no overlapping here. So finally, we can have the representation of the output sequence in graphical way here. So as we have obtained for y of 0, the amplitude level equal to 9. Again, for y of 1, we have obtained the amplitude level equal to 9. Then the amplitude level was equal to 11. Next to that, we obtained the amplitude level equal to 5. And lastly, in the previous case, we have obtained the amplitude level equal to 2. And for this case and beyond, we have the amplitudes equal to 0. So no need to write all those amplitude levels here. So in the output sequence, we will be having these much of samples only. So this was the simplest problem to practice the convolution operation, and that convolution operation we have seen with the help of the graphical method here. Now, as I said, there is another method, which is a shortcut method, you can say, which is also named to be a tabular method or a table method, simply you can call. So we again take the problem and we will see what way the convolution can be performed by the simple tabular method here. So this time we take the problem statement to be given the following two rectangular sequences, and let us convolve them using the tabular method or simply the table method. We have h of n and x of n here. So here you see the given two discrete time sequences. The first one, input x of n, will hold the amplitude level equal to 1 for the three positions. So this is the same sequence as we have seen. So for 0th position, the first position and the second position, we have the values, and now this time it is equal to 1 only. Whereas the impulse response, here you have the value equal to 1 for n is equal to 1 and 2. Otherwise, that particular amplitude level is equal to 0. Now for performing the convolution between these two, let us see what are the steps we need to follow if we are opting the tabular methodology here. So the step number 1 will be to first of all list out the index k, those are covering a sufficient range on the input sequence. Next to that, list the input x of k. Then in the step number 3, we have to obtain the reverse sequence h of minus k, and we have to align it with the rightmost element of h of n minus k to the leftmost element of x of k here. By the step number 4, we have to make cross multiplication and we have to sum the non-zero overlapping terms to produce the output sequence y of n. So this way, one output sample can be computed here, and for obtaining the others, we have to slide h of n minus k to the right hand side by 1-1 position here. So that can be step number 5, and we have to repeat the earlier 4 steps, and we have to stop if the output values are 0 or if required here. So let us perform the tabular method of convolution for the given sequences here. So we have arranged the values for the given 2 sequences as per the steps just now we have seen. So in the first column here you see k, and in the first row we have the range, that is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. So this is what the complete range, and we have arranged the value of x of k here. Now h of minus k, the time reversal of the impulse response, then the shifted versions of this time reverse impulse response by 1-1 unit. So those we have represented as h of 1 minus k, h of 2 minus k, h of 3 minus k, h of 4 minus k, h of 5 minus k. So by 1-1 unit we have the shifting on the right hand side, and you see the matchings here, and you can have the computation of the sample values just by having 3 into 3 we get 9 for y of 0, 3 into 2 added with 1 into 3 we again obtain the value 9 for y of 1. So we have the 3 combinations to obtain y of 2. So here we have 3 into 1, 1 into 2 and 2 into 3, they are all added together, the obtained value will be equal to 11. For y of 3 it will be 1 into 1 added with 2 into 2, the value is 5. For y of 4, 2 into 1 it will be equal to 2, and elsewhere the value is equal to 0 when there is no overlapping with the input sequence and that of the time reverse and shifted version of the impulse response here. So this way also, for the given input sequence and the corresponding impulse response, the output sequence y of n we have obtained, and here it will be the same plotting of the values as we have discussed here. So this was all the procedure of the convolution operation we have seen by the two methodologies. The first one is the graphical and the second one is the tabular here. Now the convolution operation we have seen. Now there is another term in signal processing, that is deconvolution. Deconvolution is nothing but the reverse operation of the convolution here. In the convolution operation, we are obtaining the output sequence of a certain linear time invariant system by performing the convolution operation between the input sequence x of n with the unit type impulse response h of n here. When we determine the input sequence by knowing the output sequence y of n and the impulse response behavior of the given LTI system, that is nothing but the deconvolution operation. Thank you.